So hi there. It's day five after the surgery. It's a quarter after nine in the morning here. And I was up at about quarter after seven just to make sure the kids got up. My wife was gone to an early meeting. Again, I'm not doing anything in the morning right now. Just made sure they both got up and we'll send my daughter to get my son downstairs. But I did wake up and make sure they got up. And pain wasn't too bad because I took that oxycodone at about 3 a.m. and I had had one previously at about 9 p.m. So I'm going to stay on those drugs so when I wake up, I'm not in total agony. It sucks to start the day that way. So by having one at 3 a.m. and then I just took another one here about 15 minutes ago, just trying to manage that pain a little bit better. Yesterday, I noticed that my back actually started getting bad. I actually set up this YouTube channel and my battery had died on my laptop because I was on it for a while and then had to go plug it in the office, and sitting down, my back got pretty bad. And I was texting with my buddies and I was texting out the picture of my wound because I took the bandage off yesterday after my shower. I had my first shower yesterday, which was day four after the surgery. And it looks pretty good, actually. No kind of infection or anything yet. I guess that takes 5 to 7 days to show up, but I don't think I'm going to get one. It looks pretty good there. I'll try to upload a picture. It's pretty disgusting because my gut's fat, but doctor did a really good job putting everything back together. Anyways, I was texting with my one friend, Tom, and he's a registered massage therapist, and he's been doing it a little bit, and his father-in-law actually owns a company. And his uncle there, his father-in-law's brother, actually went to Germany earlier this year and had two disc replacements done. So someone else to draw a little bit of experience from. And what he said was, and I heard this on one other guy that went to Germany for this too, who gave me the idea of this video blog. He had done it, but it just, there wasn't enough information for me, which is why I'm kind of redoing it with my own experience. But that guy earlier had mentioned just how the back of his legs were very tight and even 8 months in, which is kind of what made me wonder, like, how long does this recovery take? So what Thomas told me yesterday, the RMT, was just saying that he had a lot of flexibility issues, and he called it the lumbo-pelvic complex, so the muscles in the lumbar area region. And what happens is when you get those new discs in, first off, mine were so bad and they were also like compressed. So you put those new discs in, now not only has everything had to stretch down there, I'm guessing, but the tilt is different. So my pelvic tilt is a little bit differently now. So I think that just took a few days to actually start setting in for those to actually start getting sore, if that makes any sense. So, you know, the first few days I'm like, oh, I don't have any back pain. Cause I tweaked my back before the week before the surgery, and I remembered why it's so bad, but I didn't have any back pain for the first few days after, and yesterday was the first day, and then I talked to Tom there, and he just said, well, you know, you're probably a little bit higher now, like taller, and that pelvic tilt now, because those discs are in there, it's changed everything, so there's tendons, there's ligaments, there's muscles, everything has to start adjusting now. Again, I'm no doctor here, but I'm just guessing there. So that's probably what's causing my discomfort in my lower back. So what I'm going to do today, and I've been walking around, I've been up my feet for about 15 minutes. So I'm just walking around and walking in place here. If you can see that, I just do that and I try to lift my knees up a little bit more. It doesn't really cause any pressure. So I'm just going to do a lot more of that today and just try to get those muscles working more. Again, I'm down in here. And I haven't found the right, where is that? See that blanket? I haven't found the right way to put that blanket again to support, you know, my lower back. But I've been sitting in that recliner. It's pretty good. But again, my back is sore. So I want to just amp up the activity today and just see if that's going to help me, you know, by tomorrow, obviously, see if it's going to be a little bit less. And obviously, I'm not going to be doing any stretching exercises yet. But just get on more activity and walking and see how that helps. So I'll give you an update. I still haven't gone number two yet. So that's been since Thursday morning. It's now Tuesday morning. Haven't even had an inkling, but my guts are working better because I'm passing gas a little bit easier. And last night I was even able to to push just a little bit when I felt the pressure in there, because it's not that comfy, but again, not a big deal. But I was able to start pushing around 9 to 11 o'clock last night, just a little bit, just, you know, for about 30 seconds, just, again, just a little bit. And you know, I'd actually pass some gas, so who knew life would revolve around passing gas like that, but it does. So anyways, that's a little bit of an update. Day 5 from the lumbar disc replacements, L3-L4. Probably should have said that at the beginning, but you can see all these videos now. They should all be in a row there on that lumbar disc replacement YouTube channel. Anyways, feel free to leave a comment down there and I'll make sure I figure out how to turn those notifications on so I'll actually get a notification when somebody comments. Anyways, hope you have a good day and we'll talk to you soon.